Good morning, friends. Welcome to the concept of probability. After a discussion of permutation and combination, the next topic in the series is concept of probability. It's a very important topic for CAT point of view as well as for the banking examination. Also for SNAP exam, number of questions are being asked from the concept of probability. When we talk about the probability, in general sense, probability means chance of happening an event. What do you mean by the term probability? By the term probability, we mean chance of happening an event, right? How to find the chances? The basic definition for the probability is that would be taken as number of favorable cases divided by number of total cases. Number of favorable cases divided by number of total cases. Now for finding the questions of favorable cases and total cases, we apply the concept of permutation and combination. The first variety of statement which are based on the concept of permutation and combination that is used for finding the number of favorable cases as well as for finding our total number of cases. So in starting, I am going to take some examples in which we have to find the probability and also we have to use the concept of permutation and combination. For example, I am going to take first example here. One word is given apple, right? And words are formed by using the alphabet of it. Question is, what is the probability of a word in which both P are together? Both P's are together. Means one word is given apple, we have to use the alphabet of the word apple, right? And the question is, what is the probability that both P's are together? Okay. Now what I can say that for finding my probability, I need total number of cases as well as total number of favorable cases. When I take total number of cases, because 5 alphabets are there and 2 P are repeated, as I told in permutation combination, that would be 5 factorial upon 2 factorial. Now secondly, I have to find my favorable cases. It is given in the question that 2 P's are together. So I will make a group of 2 P's. One group is there. Then we have A, then we have L, and then we have E. Now 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay. So here I can say I have 4 alphabets. That is said to be 4 factorial. Okay. And these two are repeated, but that is a part of a single group. It means I may take it as upon 1. I will take it as a 2 factorial upon 2 factorial, that would be 1. Then I can say my number of favorable cases are 4 factorial, right? Now I have to answer my question, I have to find the probability. My answer is said to be 4 factorial divided by 5 factorial upon 2. So that would be taken as 2 into 4 factorial upon 5 factorial. This would be cancelled out. I may say answer is said to be 2 upon 5. That is the answer to my question. So I may say that the probability of getting the word where both P's are together, that is said to be 2 upon 5. That becomes my answer. I hope it's clear. Similarly, we take one more example here. It is given that we have 3 boys and 4 girls. They have to be arranged in a row. They have to be arranged in a row. Such that, what is the probability that all boys will be together? What is the probability that all boys sit together? That is our question. All boys sit together, right? Now I have to answer this question. What I can say that 3 boys and 4 girls. Okay. First I will try to find my total cases. Here my total number of persons are said to be 7. So I may say total cases are equal to 7 factorial. Right? That's my total cases. Now in the second case, I have to find my favorable case that states me 3 boys and 4 girls, boys are together. So I will make a single group of the boys and 4 girls are there, G1, G2, G3 and G4. That information is provided to us. The 3 boys are together and 4 girls are there, right? Now the next step is I have to arrange them. My total units are 5, so I may take it as 5 factorial upon, right? That is 5 factorial. After that, into... Now I have to arrange the boys also, that is said to be 3 factorial. The my answer is said to be 5 factorial into 3 factorial. That is the arrangement of the boys. Now in the answer, we have to find the probability. That is said to be favorable cases upon total cases, so I may take it as 5 factorial into 3 factorial upon 7 factorial, right? That may be taken as 3 into 2, and in the denominator I may say 7 into 6, because the rest 5 factorial will be cancelled with 5 factorial, 6 will be cancelled out, I may say my answer is said to be 1 upon 7. So that is the probability of arranging all the 7 students in a row such that all boys will be together. So my answer is said to be 1 upon 7. I hope the idea is clear, right? It means the basic formula of probability, that is number of favorable cases by total cases, requires that we have to use permutation and combination in order to find by total cases as well as the favorable cases. Now here we use three terms. The first thing is the probability, whose formula is number of favorable cases divided by total number of cases upon total number of cases, right? After that, the second is odds in favor. The second concept is said to be odds in favor. By the term odds in favor, we mean that favorable cases by unfavorable cases. Odds in favor means favorable cases upon unfavorable cases. And third one is odds against favor. Third one is said to be odds against favor. Odds against favor means unfavorable cases upon favorable cases. That is said to be unfavorable upon favorable. So we have here the three formulas, although all three are interrelated. Why? Because we know that total cases includes both favorable and unfavorable. Total cases is equal to favorable events plus unfavorable cases, right? It means if we have out of these three anything, suppose in the question it is given that the probability of happening an event is 1 by 4. The probability of happening an event is 1 by 4. We have to find out what is the odds in favor, as well as we have to find out what is the odds against favor. These two questions are there. We have to find out what is odds in favor, as well as we have to find out what is odds against favor. Here the probability is said to be 1 by 5. It means that my favorable cases are 1 and total cases are 4. It means favorable are 1 and total are 4. It means my unfavorable cases are 3. In the first question, I have to find out odds in favor. That is favorable upon unfavorable. That is said to be 1 upon 3. In the second question, I have to find odds against favor. That is unfavorable upon favorable. That is 3 upon 1. So I will say that odds in favor in this question is said to be 1 by 3. Odds against favor is said to be 3 upon 1. Similarly, if odds in favor is given, odds in favor of an event is given, that is said to be 2 upon 3. That is given to you. You have to find out what is the probability. Okay. Now if I say odds in favor is 2 upon 3, means my favorable cases are 2 and unfavorable cases are 3. So I may say that my total probability is said to be 2 upon 5. Why it is 2 upon 5? Because my favorable cases are 2 and total cases are 5. So I may say that the probability is said to be 2 upon 5. So that is the second aspect of this topic, that is how to find the favorable cases and unfavorable cases. Next, after understanding of favorable cases, probability, odds in favor and odds against favor, the next point that we are going to understand here is we use some specific terms here. For example, the first term that we use, that is said to be sample space. Second term, we use biased event, unbiased. When we consider the sample space means total possible outcome. Suppose a dice is thrown, so I may say that the total possible outcomes are, it may either show 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I may say that the sample space is the all possible outcomes. Now we have two types of events, biased and unbiased. What do you mean by the biased and unbiased? Suppose a coin has been tossed. If it is unbiased, we may say there are two cases, either head or tail. So what is the probability of head is 1 by 2 and tail is 1 by 2 because it is unbiased. If that is biased, it may be specified in the question that suppose it is given that the probability of getting head is 1 by 3. It means we can say the toss is biased because the probabilities are not same. Now we are going to start here some different varieties of question. First I am going to start with the concept that based with the dices. First I am going to start with the concept of dices, right? When a dice is thrown, total faces are 6, it may either show 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So here we can take some different cases. When one dice is thrown, when two dices are thrown, three dices are thrown, four dices are thrown, and so on. Right? When one dice is thrown, my total possible outcomes are equal to 6. It may either show 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. When two dices are thrown, total outcomes are 6 into 6, that is said to be 36. How it is 36? Suppose 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6. Then 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3 up to 2, 6. Then 3, 1, 3, 2, 3, 3 up to 3, 6. And so on. So here I can say when two dices are thrown, I may say total possible outcomes are said to be 36. When the three dices are thrown, that may be 6 into 6 into 6. So we may say that is said to be 216. When four dices are thrown, 6 into 6 into 6 into 6. So I may say that is said to be 1296. That are my all possible outcomes. I hope it's clear. Now we may have the different number of questions based over this. Suppose I am going to start with first problem is if two dices are thrown, what is the probability that both faces will show same, right? Two dices are thrown and we have to find the probability that both faces will show the same number. So here again, say two dices are thrown, total sample space is 36, that we know. And after that, both faces will show the same number. It means we have the six numbers there. Both may show either 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. So my favorable cases are 6. So I can say the probability is said to be 1 upon 6. That becomes my answer. So answer to my question is probability is 1 upon 6. We may also take one more example here. Suppose two dices are thrown. What is the probability that some on the faces of dices is less than equal to 4? Two dices are thrown. We have to find out what is the probability that some on the faces of dices is less than equal to 4. It means we know that when two dices are thrown, the sum, minimum sum must be 2. The sum may be either 2, it may be either 3, it may be either 4, because it is less than equal to 4. When the sum is 2, we have only single case, that is 1 and 1. When sum is 3, we may take 1, 2 and 2, 1. When sum is 4, we may take 1, 3, 2, 2 and 3, 1. Right? Here my possible outcomes are, we know that the possible two dices are thrown, possible cases are 36 and favorable cases are 3 and 3, 6. 6 upon 36, my answer is said to be 1 upon 6. So here also I can say that when two dices are thrown and it is given that the sum on the faces is less than equal to 3, so I may say that answer is said to be 1 upon 6. We may also extend the question. For example, it is given that the three dices are thrown and sum on the faces of the dices is 15. You have to find what is the probability of getting the sum to be 15. Okay. Now we can say when three dices are thrown, first of all we have to find the sum to be 15. How to find the sum to be 15? For that we can apply. It may be either 5 plus 5 plus 5. It may be either 4 plus 5 plus 6. It may be 3 plus 6 plus 6, right? Or take any other case where you can apply. We have taken 4, 5, 6. We may take 3, 5, 6. No, we may take 3, 6, 6, right? Now we have to take the all possible outcomes. With a pair of 5, 5, 5, there is only one case possible. Second is 4, 5, 6. It may be 4, 56. It may be 4, 6, 5. It may be 5, 4, 6, 5, 6, 4. It may be 6, 4, 5, 6, 5, 4. That is 3. So we can say 3 factorial, this is equal to 6. Next we have 3, 6, 6. If we have to find it, 3, we may take it as 3 factorial and 2 are repeated, that is 2 factorial, that is said to be 3. So I may say that in this question, माय फेवरेबल केसेस आर 6 प्लस 3 9 एंड 1 10 एंड माय टोटल केसेस आर इक्वल टू 216 बिकॉज 3 डाइसेस आर थ्रोन तो आई मे से दैट माय आंसर इज सेड टू बी प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ गेटिंग द सम टू बी 15 इज 216 दैट बिकम्स माय आंसर क्वेश्चंस आर वेरी सिंपल ओनली व्हाट यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट यू हैव टू जस्ट फाइंड आउट व्हाट आर द पॉसिबल आउटकम्स सो दैट यू आर इन ए पोजिशन टू गेट योर आंसर Here we will take one more example here in which in case of 2 the in case of 3 4 dices are thrown it is given that 4 dices are thrown we have to find out what is the probability that sum on the faces of the dices is 20 here the question is sum on the face of the dices is 20 it means we have to make the different cases we may say 6 6 6 and 2 because we may say 18 plus 2 is 20 similarly we may say 6 6 5 and 3 that is 12 plus 8, 20. Then we may say 6, 6, 4 and 4. Then we may say 6, 5, 5 and 4. Here the sum is also 20. And also I may say 5, 5, 5 and 5. In all these cases we can say the sum on the faces is 20. Now in order to get my answer, what process I can apply? I have to find the all possible outcomes. For that, I will take the first case 6, 6, 6, 2. In that the three numbers are repeated. So for taking my total cases, I may say 4 factorial upon 3 factorial, which is equal to 4. Second case, two numbers are repeated, 4 factorial upon 2 factorial, 24 upon 2. So that value is equal to 12. In this case, 2 are repeated, 2 6 and 2 4, 2 factorial into 2 factorial. So I may say this is 24 by 4. This value is said to be 6. In the third case, that is 4 factorial upon 2 factorial. This is equal to 12. In last case, it is equal to 1. So all these are my possible outcomes, or I can say all these are my favorable cases. So I may add all the numbers 12, 12, 24, 6, 30, 34, and 1, 35. Right? So I may say that my favorable cases are said to be 35. And then we have to take the total cases. So for taking my total cases, because 4 dices are thrown, so I may say that total cases is said to be 6 into 6 into 6 into 6. So my answer is said to be 35 upon 1296. That is my total number of, is my probability of throwing 4 dices in which sum on the faces of the dices is equal to 20. After dices, the next point is that deals with concept of coins. Okay, suppose if I say we have one coin and one coin is thrown, so we may either get head or we may get tail. Here I can say my sample space is said to be H and T. If two coins are thrown, so we may say either we get two heads or one head, one tail. Or first head, then tail, then head, then both tails. So we have total four outcomes here. If I say we have to throw three coins, it means my total outcomes are 8. Because when we say one coin is thrown, the two outcomes are there, 2 into 2 into 2, that is said to be 8. What are my possible sample space? It may be 3H, 2H, 1T. It may be HTH, it may be THH, or I may say 3T or 2T and 1H, THT, or it may be HTT. Finally, I can say we have total 8 outcomes here. Okay. If my coins increases, suppose we have 4 coins, we have 5 coins, it is very difficult for us to make the sample space. And sometimes questions are asked which are directly based over that. For example, if I say 3 coins are thrown, 3 coins are thrown, what is the probability of getting exactly 2 heads? 3 coins are thrown. What is the probability of getting exactly 2 heads, right? So when I say 3 coins are thrown, in that case, I can simply say that when 3 coins are thrown, I may say total outcomes are equal to 8. Okay. And 2 heads are there. So I just find here 2 heads, 1 case, 2 case and 3 case. तो माय प्रोबेबिलिटी सेट टू बी 3/8. आई कैन इजीली आंसर इट बाय यूजिंग द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ माय सैंपल स्पेस. आई कैन आंसर इट. बट अवर प्रॉब्लम स्टार्ट्स व्हेन नंबर ऑफ कॉइंस आर मोर. सपोज इट इज गिवन दैट देर आर 10 कॉइंस. 10 कॉइंस आर थ्रोन. वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट व्हाट इज द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ गेटिंग एग्जैक्टली 4 heads. 10 coins are thrown. We have to find out what is the probability of getting exactly 4 heads. Okay. Now for these type of question, it is very difficult for us to make the sample space. So what process we apply for answering these type of questions? For these questions, we apply the concept of binomial distribution. So now here first we try to understand the concept of binomial distribution. For applying the concept of binomial distribution, the first thing must be there, events must be complementary to each other. The first thing that we have to know, event must be complementary to each other. Suppose if I say 2 coins are tossed, suppose 1 coin is tossed, so we have 2 outcomes, head and tail, and the complementary event by that term we mean that where the sum of their probability is equal to 1. Suppose if I say probability of getting head is 1/3. So we can simply say that the probability of getting the tail is 2/3. Why? Because they are said to be complementary events. What the formula is? NCR P raised to power R 1 minus P raised to power N minus R. What is the formula here is? What is the formula for finding the probability when number of events are big? The formula is NCR P raised to power R into 1 minus P raised to power N minus R. How we can apply this? What is the process for that? Here n is the total outcome. Suppose we take this example, 10 outcomes and we have to get exactly 4 heads. So I can say that n is total coins thrown, or total things. So here I can say n is equal to 10. R is the favorable. I need 4 heads. So I can say R is favorable. I need 4 heads. P is the probability of favorable event. P is probability of favorable outcome. What we require here? Here we require head, right? If coin is unbiased, we may say probability of getting head is equal to 1/2. That is said to be 1/2. Now what we can say that now we have all the things here. 10 coins are thrown. We may take it as 10c4, 1/2 raised to power 4, 1 minus 1/2 raised to power 10 minus 4, that is 6. So I may take it as 10c4. 1/2 raised to power 4 into 1/2 raised to power 6. Okay, my final answer is said to be 10c4 into 1/2 raised to power 10. So I can say that what is the probability of getting exactly 4 heads is 10c4 into 1/2 raised to power 10. That becomes my answer. So that is a step by which we have understood the concept of binomial distribution. This concept is generally used where the number of events are big, right? Where the events are big, where we can apply it. But for applying this, one thing you have to take care of, events must be complementary to each other. If the events are complementary, only in that case we can apply this process. After the concept of coins, the next aspect that we are going to discuss in the topic of probability is questions based on the concept of cards. Right? Before starting with the question, first of all, there is a need to understand about the structure of the cards. In a pack of cards, we have total 52 cards that are being divided into based on the colors. We have the red color in that, as well as we have the black color. 26 cards are of red and 26 cards are of black. Then we have the faces. Then after we have the suits. We have 4 suits here. Heart, diamond, club and spade. So we can say that for the red color, that are divided in 2 parts. The first one is the diamonds and the second one is the heart. For the black, we have the club and spades. 13 cards are of each, 13 diamond, 13 heart, 13 club and 13 spade. Then we have two more type of cards. The first one is named as the honored cards. Honored card starts with ace, king, queen, jack. Means every suit there are four honored cards. In total we can say there are 16 honored cards. Then we have the face cards. Face cards are same as to the honored except A. It means K, Q and Z. Right? In a suit there are three face cards. In total there are 12 face cards. So it is a description about the cards, right? Now we may have some different type of questions here. Suppose it is given that find the two cards are drawn. What is the probability that both cards are kings? The question is, two cards are drawn. What is the probability that both cards are kings? Now we know that in order to solve any question of probability, we have two things. Number of favorable cases by number of total cases. Now when we say that total cases, total we have 52 cards, my total cases are 52 C2, right? And both must be kings. In total I have 4 kings, so that is said to be 4 C2. So my answer is said to be 4 C2 upon 52 C2, that becomes my answer. So that is the concept of the cards. In these type of questions, whatever question we have, in each and every question, the statement is asked in such a way that you have to answer the question in this particular structure. In these questions, two things have been taken care of. One thing is whether cards are drawn at random or cards are drawn one by one or cards are drawn one by one with replacement. Cards are drawn one by one with replacement. We have to take care of all the things. When we draw the card one by one, we have to start our counting. Suppose if I say two cards are drawn, what is the probability that both cards are diamonds? It is given that the cards are drawn one by one, right? First I will draw the first card. We have total 13 diamonds. My probability is 13 upon 52. Then I am going to draw the second card. Now total cards are left that are equal to 51, and the card number 2 is, now my diamonds are 12. My answer is said to be 13 upon 52 into 12 upon 51. That process we apply when we are drawing the cards one by one. Similarly, if the question is the cards are drawn one by one with replacement, it means drawing of the first card 13 upon 52, second card also 13 upon 52, because that is with replacement. It means earlier I have 52 cards in total. The card that I have taken, that is being replaced. Now my total cards are again 52. So I will take it as 13 upon 52 into 13 upon 52. That becomes my answer. I hope the idea is clear. So these type of questions are being asked in such statements. We may take one more example here. It is given that from a pack of 52 cards, from a pack of 52 cards, 4 cards are drawn, 4 cards are drawn such that they are of different colors, such that they are of different suits and different faces, means different numbered, right? So we can say that out of the 52 cards we have to draw 4 cards such that they are of the different suits as well as of different faces. Now we have to draw 4 cards here and they are being drawn one by one. So when I take the, it depends on the question, either they are taken as one by one or in at a random. So we can take both cases. If they are drawn at random, means collectively, in that case we may say the denominator is taken as 52 C4. 4 card we have taken. Now when I talk about the first card, it may be out of 52, it may be anyone 52, right? Now we can say that we have 4 suits: diamond, heart, club and spade, and every card contains 13 13 13 and 13. Suppose one card has been drawn. It may be any of the suit, it may be either club or heart. I have taken out of 52. Then these 13 cards have been left, and whatever the number I have taken, that is also left. So how much cards are left now? 12, 12, and 12. For the second case, my total cards left are equal to 36. After that, one card is taken. Now that suit is completely ended, and the number is ended. Now how much cards are left? 11 and 11. So we will take that is equal to 22. And finally, I have taken this. How much cards are left? 10. So that is said to be 52 into 36 into 22 into 10 upon 52 C 4. That may be the case where we have taken them at a random. If they are taken one by one, we may take it as 52 upon 52 into 36 upon 51 into 22 upon 50 and finally 10 upon 49. In that case, my answer will be this one. That is the case where we have drawn the card one by one. In generally, when nothing is mentioned, we take the first one case, we take in total. But if it specifies in the question that we are going to take the cards one by one, in that case, we have to apply this process in order to get our answer. I hope the idea is clear. Now, after understanding of this concept, the next point that we are here to understand is, we use some more terms here. First one is mutually exclusive. Mutually exclusive. Second one is non-mutually exclusive. Second one is non-mutually exclusive. When we consider the mutually exclusive, it means, I may say that the probability of selecting a driver, if he met with an accident and is a truck driver, the probability is said to be 3 upon 32. That becomes my answer. I hope everyone in this class have understood the concept of the Bayes theorem. These type of questions generally are not asked in our MBA examinations, but because it deals with the concept of probability, so there may be a chances of asking of these type of statements. Thank you very much.